My name is Michael Chan. I am an assistant professor of radiation oncology here at Wake Forest Baptist Health. I am the co-director of the Gamma Knife program here. So our Gamma Knife team is one of the most experienced teams in the country. We routinely are among the busiest Gamma Knife centers in the country. I think the past year we're the third busiest in the country. We have a team of neurosurgeons, radiation oncologists, and medical physicists who are quite experienced. We have had our Gamma Knife here since 1999. We have the Gamma Knife Perfection, which is the newest and most state-of-the-art version of the Gamma Knife. The Gamma Knife procedure is essentially a one-day procedure. Patients come in and they initially meet with the neurosurgeon, and the neurosurgeon has to put on a head frame to basically hold the patient's head into place, because the radiation beams during the Gamma Knife procedure are so precise that we really need to make sure that there's zero movement at all, because the precision of the Gamma Knife is essentially on the order of less than a millimeter accuracy. Then they undergo an MRI or CAT scan with the frame on, essentially to establish coordinates so that the computer knows exactly what is where. At that point, the radiation oncologist and neurosurgeon put together the radiosurgical plan. During that time, we often have collaboration with our radiologists and with our medical physicists, mainly so that we know that we're not missing anything, and also so that we can assure that the plan is perfect. When they're actually in the procedure, they're essentially in there for anywhere from 20 minutes to a couple hours. During that time, they don't feel a thing. They hear a little music in the background. That's about it. They get here about 6:45 in the morning, and they can be done anywhere from 10:30 in the morning until sometime in the afternoon. Regarding communications with referring physicians, in general, what happens is that when the patients generally see us, both myself and one of our neurosurgeons, for a consultation, sometime prior to their Gamma Knife procedure. What happens during the consultation is we counsel the patients on and essentially educate them on what will happen during the Gamma Knife and what the risks and the benefits and alternatives of treatment are. And after that visit, we send a letter to the referring physicians regarding what has transpired and what our recommendations would be. It's not all the time where Gamma Knife is the best option. There are some times where surgery is the better option, or whole brain radiotherapy, or fractionated radiotherapy, but essentially what the patient is getting is an expert opinion from a multidisciplinary team, including radiation oncologists and neurosurgeons. When patients do really have minimal disease in the brain, like one or two brain metastases, something like Gamma Knife, which is very focused radiation and just targeted at the sites where you want to treat, can be quite successful, but also without the same toxicities as patients get when they receive whole brain radiation.